Christmas ornament time!
Christmas ornament time.
So you mail in your Christmas ornaments, we hang them on our tree. This is interesting.
What is this here?
Well, it's like a blank slate and you can write whatever you want on it. So we'll just write...
Chalupa.
Wake up!
We'll be right back. That was like a hard rock wake up. Come on, Jason. It's one of your favorite shows. Sitcom Friday.
Sitcom Friday. No idea. Not a memorable song.
It is. What? Because remember, he always wants to eat the cat.
Oh, Elf.
Elf, good morning. Welcome to Wake Up.
Where we wake up.
I'm Pastor Scott.
Pastor Jason. We have Real Talk Kim with us, which if you want to know more about her, oh my gosh, she's legend. Gosh.
Follow on Instagram. Her Instagram page is one of it pops up every day. It always brings a smile.
Yeah. Oh.
Because it's so encouraging. And really, a lot of your target is to women and single women that are putting up with the guy, the da-da-da. Yeah. And
what
and
did you say? You said if you want Boaz, you got to get rid of Bozo.
Bozo.
That's one of my favorites.
We got a scripture for the day. We're going to pray over the day. Where are we at today?
2 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse 17 and verse 18. By the way, if you're a new subscriber, type in where you're from. We love to read that on Wednesdays. It says this, for our light. This is Paul talking, and he's in it. Like, he's in the thick of it. He has been... He's been in trouble.
Right.
And he says, for our light affliction, which is but for a moment, which so when he says light affliction, like it's not.
No, for him, his affliction is pretty aggressive.
So he's prophesying to his affliction.
Yeah.
He says, for our light affliction, which is but for a moment, is working for us far more exceeding an eternal weight of glory. Verse 18, while we do not look at the things which are seen, but are things which are not seen, for the things which are seen are temporary, but the things which are not seen are eternal.
Oh, it's so good.
And is that not the truth?
Right.
Like every single thing that we've gone through in our life that we hate.
Right.
It's given us more life college and we ain't got to pay one student loan back.
No, it's
true. You
know
what I'm saying? It's like it gives you some oil.
Right.
That thing that you wish to God you didn't have to go through or that you're going through right now, it has given you some oil.
My 14 businesses that failed, they gave me a Harvard education in business.
Of what not to do.
If I wouldn't have had to, right? Who starts a cheese company? And so...
You started a cheese company?
Yeah, a nacho cheese company.
Okay.
Well.
That's what I never heard of
it. I haven't ever heard of it.
I never even knew it.
You didn't even know I had a limo company, probably.
I remember the limo company.
Yeah, that was great. Yeah. Let me drive you around and lose money. It was a great idea. No, I loved it. It was my favorite idea ever.
Is he serious?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Had a cheese company?
I remember the limo company.
Had a cheese company.
Had a toy company.
I had 14 businesses that
failed.
I
really love that you ain't scared.
No, that's the secret.
Gosh.
You learn, that now we're giving a business idea.
Yes.
Because they say 9 out of 10 businesses fail, and most people go, well, I'm not going to start a business. But highly successful people go, I only have to start 10 businesses to become successful. I, of course, I'm below average, so I had to start 14.
Okay.
That's the truth, though. You know, there's so many people watching today that have goals that God has given them purpose and destiny on the inside of them, and they're afraid of what people are going to think about them.
Wow. Yeah,
what if I write that book and nobody buys it? Mm-hmm. Who wants to read my story? What if I start that company and no one supports me?
Nobody wants cheese.
But you didn't quit there, you know? So I think we got to realize that failure isn't failure just because you fail at something. Failure's failure when you stay down and not
What if Jesus stopped just because people didn't like him?
Come on.
I mean, this is Jesus.
This is dumb. I went to that city. I preached. I healed people. You know what? I'm not going to do this anymore. I'm out.
I feed 5,000 people. Me. Nobody brings a sandwich?
You know, I just want to thank you.
I had to do it all.
I get 10 lepers. Only one of them comes back and says, thank you. I'm out.
Come on. Man, that is good. I'm out. I'm done. I got to do all the work. Nobody thanks me.
When you teach a kid how to ride a bike, and I taught my kids how to ride bikes, all of them.
Yeah.
You know, all of them had to go through the fall. That's part of the process.
Right. And I hate it.
And as a dad, I had to go, like at some point, I'm riding, I'm running as fast as I can and holding on to everything. But at some point, you just have to go, okay, you're going to fall. Like, I know you're going to fall. Right. And I know that that's the process. Uh-huh. You have to fall in order to learn how to ride this.
But you know what? They don't quit.
No.
No.
That's why I think God tells us to have childlike faith. They get right back up again with all the blood coming out of their knees, and they try again. We as adults, we stop. Oh, my God, it failed. Oh. I lost my 401k. I'm stuck.
Yeah.
I asked her out. She said, no, I'll never talk to another girl again.
I don't want no man. But you want a man. You know you want a man, but it failed. So you're over here walking around bleeding on people that didn't pay you.
Right. And how long do they wait to get back on the bike? And oftentimes I'll talk to people.
Man, I love
like, I'm
that.
Just not ready. I know this guy, you know, he's, but, you
this
know.
This is a good
and
point. And I'm no, like, you bring up well, a good how, thing. Well, how, I've been hurt before. Well, I'm guarded.
Oh, you know, when was the last relationship? It's been a couple of years. Get on the bike. What Come are you on. Doing? Why would and you want to wait one extra day
God, that's
from
good.
The person that God has for
and
you?
And don't drag that old story into your new
right.
story.
Yes.
Like, why do you want to repeat that or talk about it? Just let it go.
Forget those things that are in the past.
Come
you
on.
Know, the worst breakup I ever had happened on Wednesday, and I saw Holly on Sunday. And I think that's
Man.
The way that you got to live. You're like, you don't want me? That's all right. Hello.
Yes.
And
that,
it's got to be
rejection
that quick.
Rejection was God's Wait. Protection.
But how do you do it? Hello.
Hello.
Is it me? You're looking for.
Oh my gosh, we're in tune.
Yeah. Oh, I love
One
this.
Of the things you talked about your story and how you fell down.
Yeah.
And you said this phrase that the Lord was talking to you and he said, I needed you to unbecome what you became.
Yeah.
Because you were trying to fit into places I never created you to be.
That's so good.
Could you just talk about that for a second? Because I was listening to it going, there's a lot in there,
yeah,
what you just
right.
said.
A lot of meat.
You know, I was raised in religion. My daddy was a preacher. My mom was a great house mom. And I just had all of these ideas of what I could be and what I couldn't be. And I started getting thwarted. So I started, man, I was wearing St. John suits, which y'all probably don't know about this, but all the girls will, that all the pastor's wives were wearing them. So I thought, let me just squeeze myself into them. Should not have been in them. I look like Pillsbury Doughboy. Like,
stop.
And, but I was being an Ann Taylor when God created me to be a Betsy Johnson. And I think that we become all the things that society tells us, the trends,
right, yeah.
what's popular. It worked for my mom for 52 years.
Right.
She had a phenomenal marriage. Then all of a sudden now I'm over here trying to unbecome. When my world comes crashing down, I had to ask God, what did you want from me? And you know what he told me? I'm about to take you places that nobody in your family's ever been. You're about to be a trailblazer in your family. And so I need you to unlearn all of those things that you put yourself in a box, trying to be like her, trying to cook like her, trying to be, you know?
Yeah.
And so
Actually, I do
went
know.
On a journey
right.
yeah.
for 4 years, literally unbecoming.
Wow.
I'm not the pastor my dad was.
No.
I'm preaching on platforms they would never even think to preach on. I've written 5 books. Nobody in my family ever wrote a book. I had to figure all these things out, but I had to unlearn what they told me I was supposed to look like and be like.
Wow.
In order to get where God wanted.
Because you
me
make
to
a
go.
Bad them, but you make a great you.
Yes, I make a great me.
You are. There's not another you.
No.
You're,
I
the
know
best
my
you.
Lane, but it's because I unlearned.
And that's what people have to learn to do is because oftentimes we watch the television.
Yes.
We look at People Magazine and we're trying to say, oh, I got to be like that. I got to be like this. And my parents said I have to be like this. And no. Be who God
and
made you
church,
to be.
And the church, y'all. I don't look like any other preacher. It would be real easy for me to try to hoop and try to wear the little big stilettos and preach, you know, trying to be real, real, real feminine. I know who I am.
Wow.
God created me to be girly, but
to
out
stand
there.
Out.
Yeah.
You are called to stand out.
Yeah.
Be a bright light.
Yeah, and let people feel that freedom.
And sometimes when we're trying to fit in, like you said, then we find ourselves wrecked.
Right.
Right? Here's the train wreck.
Wrecked. Mm.
And so here's the revelation. For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, is working for us.
Yeah.
And so the mess that you were living in,
wow.
God caused the mess to work for you.
Man, that's good.
It began to produce in you. Like it was facing you hit rock bottom, but then you said you found at the bottom.
Was Jesus.
Was the rock.
Was the rock.
That was so smart.
Which
was that
Jesus.
Was so brilliant. Is that sometimes it takes those afflictions for us to go, okay, well, the what then?
Yeah.
What? And so maybe you're in a spot right now in your life where you're just like, what? And allow God now to become
so
your builder.
Good.
That you're a living stone. Allow yourself to become the unique you. Stop listening to what everyone else is saying that you need to be or what everyone else has spoken into your life.
Yes.
And go to the Word of God. What does He say about me? How did He build me? Because He built me exactly for the race He has in front of me. And my race is unique to, there's no one else that has my purpose.
No.
There's no one else that has your purpose. There's,
no.
Nobody's gonna steal your purpose. Nobody's gonna get your destiny. It's for you. God is reserving
so good,
it for
Jason.
You, but He needs you to be
so
you to
good.
Run it.
So good, Pastor.
Love it.
Yeah.
Sometimes gotta wreck your plans. If He sees your plans, are gonna wreck you.
Oh, that's so good. You wanna pray over their day?
Yes.
So good.
You pray.
Father, we just thank you right now for wrecking our plans. We thank you right now, God, that you know things that we don't even know. So, Lord, we thank you for this scripture. We thank you today that you're using our scars and you're turning them into stars today, that you're turning our wounds into wisdom, and that nothing behind us is greater than what you're bringing into our life. We're walking in Ephesians 3:20 today. You're going to do exceedingly abundantly, more than we could ever ask or think if we let go and let you. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Well, they get a text. If you want to get a text every morning from us,
yes,
it makes it simple. All you do is click on the text, and it'll take you right to our wake-up show every morning.
So you can
morning.
Sign up for that text by texting the number on your screen with the message that it tells you to message. And don't forget to be in church this weekend.
Yeah. Yes.
Y'all got the greatest church. Y'all missing out. Great community.
If you live local, come here. But if you don't, you can find a
wherever
great church.
Wherever your church is, yeah, just be in God's house. Yeah. Be in the park. There's a lot of churches doing the parking lot thing.
Yeah, for sure.
And don't be at Bedside Baptist.
I don't know what that is.
Baptist.
Where you get used to sitting in the house just on your in your bed in your jammies, which has gotten real comfortable this year.
It has.
Yeah, come in your jammies here.
Yes.
We like jammies.
Jammies.
Jammies Sunday. Slippers.
Jammy Sunday is my favorite Sunday. Yeah. It's like when I pick up my daughter and I'm like, hey, today I'm going to be shirtless dad. And she's like, Dad, don't be shirtless dad. Nobody likes shirtless
dad. It's shirtless dad day. What am I going to do?
Yeah, I can't
shirt's gotta come
shirtless
off.
Dad. Oh, I love that. So annoyed. We'll see you tomorrow.
I got a visual.